Welcome back. I was trying to figure out the you know, how to get the OE user configured unlocked on your system. Basically just what I did. I unlocked that user. I just used the auto user OE account unlock, and then I used the and then I assigned a password to that user. So basically, so now I'm actually connected as that. So basically, again, so I'm logging as an OE user, and also, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna go back to my Streams account. And as you can remember, I had created my queue. I also created my streams for the target database. So let me do this. Connect streams admin / streams admin at Dynos. Again, this is my target database. Connect as OE. Let me go back. And again, streams admin at Kronos. Connected. Okay. So basically, I already have my queue created. So what I can do now is I can actually do this. Select queue name from all _ apply. And basically, yeah, now I'll be able to see what my queue name is. So. With queues, you have to go to the process. So if you would do this, _ apply, basically you have access to the apply name, the queue name, the queue owner. You know, that basically what was captured. You can get who the user is that owns that queue. So let me just do that for you guys. Apply name queue. Name queue owner, apply user from _ apply. Okay, so this is kind of messy, but apply name is target stream 1, queue owner is stream admin, queue name is target queue 1, apply user is stream admin. So what I'll do now is I'm logging as my, again, so this is the configuration is made for the apply process on the target database. So now what I'll do is I will also create the stream capture process. The stream process is going to be a capture process for my source database. So what I'll do is I'm going to issue it again, sort of the same statements, but basically it's going to be this pbms _ streams _ add _ schema _ rules schema _ name oe comma streams _ type. Type is gonna be capture. Again, you have three choices: capture, apply, and then there's a third one, which is neither stream or capture. It's a different configuration. And then you have streams _ name is equal, assign it to source _ stream 1 comma, and then queue _ name, assign it as, and if you're not sure, just go back up here, go back to where you created a queue, and this is the queue name that I assigned, which is source _ queue 1. So let me type that in here, source _ queue 1 comma, include DML true comma include DDL true comma source underscore database assign. So basically, again, if you can remember what I did is on the target database, I assigned a null value for my source database. That's because, again, I kept having that error. But if I was to run this using my source database kernels, using actual service name, basically, I never receive any error. So again, just try to figure out which value works for you, null or the service name. Okay, let's figure out where I went wrong. Oh man, okay. Begin streams ADM dot. There you go. One should also be successful. Okay, so while this is what is going on, what I'll do is need to find what the next steps are. Created my pod process. And basically also what you can do is you can actually put the use this configuration to obviously just show this and make sure that you don't have any errors if anything happens. So let me make sure that I put that in there. I'm gonna apply my target database. Begin DBMS underscore apply underscore EM set parameter open command apply name. The apply name of course is target underscore stream one. The primary value is disable underscore error value and stands for no. And what did I go wrong? Begin the supply underscore ADM set parameter. This is what I'm wrong. Apply name. I just enable the no error. This just ensure that there's no error that's being thrown out. So what I do now is the queue name has been the capture process has been created as well as the queue name. So if I was to do this, queue name, queue owner, capture name, capture owner underscore capture. basically, you have the same config queue name, capture name, queue name Q1, source Q1, stream, capture name stream 1, queue owner, stream administrator, capture owner, user, streams administrator. Okay, so now what I'll do is I will, again, I'll be using the OE schema. So now I have to apply the propagation rules for my for the source database. Let me do this. Begin dbms underscore streams underscore adm dot add schema underscore propagation. And so in terms of propagation rules, basically what you can do is you can actually specify not just schema but also table, and you can have a schema propagation rule and table propagation rules, depending on which object you want to replicate, from the source to your target database. Schema underscore name assign, the schema is going to be OE, streams name assign is going to be source underscore stream 1, and then queue name. Your name is going to be source Q. Q1. Destination Q. Destination key name, assign it, target, oh, underscore Q1, or rather source underscore Q1, no, target, it's the destination, target Q1, Donald's. Okay. Streams admin dot target queue at Donald's. Okay. And include underscore DML. It's going to no, I just made a mistake. I just made a huge mistake. I should have just, I still have some parameters left. Begin. Yeah, DBMS schema configuration rules, okay. Schema name OE. Streams name stream 1. Queue name source Q1. Destination key name, target Q1, Donald's, okay. Include DML, okay. Include underscore DDL. True. Okay, close it. And let's see what went wrong. DBMS streams. Well, let me make sure. Show you. Okay. DBMS streams. Add ADM. Add schema propagation rules. Okay. Schema name OE. Streams name. Source. Let me do this. I should have a propagation file here.
more.
Okay, let me do this. So this is what I was referring to earlier. You can also have schema, you can have table population rules. So let me do this. Where did I go now? Begin DBMS schema OE. Change name. Okay. Uname. It's fine. Maybe what I should have done is maybe just target queue. There you go. Okay, include DNL true, include DDL. And what am I doing wrong here? OE, add schema preparation rules. Raw number of types of argument. Qname, destination, Qname. Source stream 1, source Q1, Q, Q1, source Q1, source stream 1. Schema name. Aggregation. Okay, let me try this. I'm just gonna try one. So it works with the schema, with the table propagation rules. Let me try this. Again, schema. Okay, so it's not the schema name that's the problem. Give me 1 second. Add schema propagation rule. Schema name OE. So if I do this, no, that's not that. Let's try this. Okay, So basically the problem is with the scheme of population rule that I'm trying to establish. Let me just make sure one more time. Add schema propagation rules. And it's exactly what I have in here. Okay, so what I'll do is, let me do this. Propagation. Let's try this. Okay. So basically, and it worked. I'm able to type this in. But I think the only difference is for this one, I actually had to put my source database. Let me try this. If I get rid of. This line. And then copy this on here. It's still running, so I'm not sure what's going on with my. But when I run this, not that. What did I have before? I think it was this one. Unit stream admin. Okay. So again, I'm not sure why it's not proper. HMOs could be capital. Anyways. So basically, I'm able to create the propagation rule for the OE schema, as you just saw. This is it. Copy. And then what I'd actually do is cut this, and then. Okay. Just to make sure one more time. There you go, says we completed. Okay, that's fine. Okay, after you're done with the propagation rules on the source database, then what you have to do is you have to create the instantiation on the target database. So basically, first thing you do is you target database, select DBMS underscore You need to get the SCN number flash. Like that get underscore system underscore chain underscore number. And the SCN number is going to be 14127. Note that down somewhere. 14 target 14691 27. That's the SCN number for my target database. And actually, no, I should have run this query on my source database and do this. Reopen the file at 14. I was wondering why that was going wrong. So source SCN is going to be 4186149. Okay, you have a system change now already, so then what you can do is now you need to configure your Active Directory. So what you do is you need to ensure your source database. So let me just make sure show user. You need to create a directory. I'm gonna go onto my file system, and basically this is gonna be the directory that I'll be creating. Create directory. Make sure I copy this. Oh, minimize it. Create directory exp. Again, I'll be exporting the data. Exp. Source stream. Let me do this. Yeah, create directory ESP stream. Add there as this is where my this is the directory that I'm gonna use to basically store my dump file, my log file that I'll be creating. Basically which is gonna have contain my change data. Let me do this. I'm gonna create the same directory on here. Because again, so I'll create on my source database and I need to create on the target to be able to retrieve it from that directory. So create directory ESP stream add data as okay. What I need to do next is I need to run exp. I'm gonna exit from my SQL Plus application. Go into my OS level, and I need to basically just run the export dump utility exp dp stream admin /streams admin at the source service is kernels schemas equal to OE directory is equal to exp stream add dump file is equals to OE1 that DMP log file is equals to OE1 dot log parallel. Parallel is equal to 4 and then flashback underscore SCN is gonna be my SCN, the SCN that I quoted earlier, which was 4186149. So now basically the data is being, it's gonna be exported to my the dump file is gonna be created for the data that's been for the data that's coming from the source database. Actually, you know what? What I'll do is I'll pause it here, and then I'll pick it back up when the after the export dump is complete. Thank you so much for watching.